Chicken game, don't look at this chicken. Game over. Well then, Mr. Sign. I guess I'll start having the attention span of someone who is always on their phone and listening to music. To make your toilet paper happy, put the top of the roll over the front. To make your toilet paper sad, put the top of the roll over in the back. Wait, since when did toilet paper have feelings? Why are their eyes closed, as if they are attempting to be satisfied? What did I do to deserve this? Pick up time. With the passage of memory, in the time vortex flow. Alright, who let the quantum physicist who knows how every second of every minute of every hour of every day of every month of every year here? I am the utmost confused. Attention. Be considerate to the public hygiene, please do not split. From Houston Court Management Office. Wait, how do you split reality? English. What the? Oh, never mind. I was going to mention that some guy probably tripped on something, but I doubt that this was the reason. Screw it, next sign. Fail. Oh my god, the guy who wrote this had to have been a fail. Ha 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 ha. Oh, it's English. Crap. It's the classic rules for the toilet. Rule 1, sit down and do your business properly. Rule 2, no peeing in the toilet standing up. Nobody wants to see your privies. Rule 3, no puking in the toilet. Don't make the staff or any user of this toilet sick. Rule 4, no squatting on top of the toilet, as if to do a cannonball. Chances are that not only will you embarrass anyone who sees this vile act, but if you actually attempted the cannonball, you'd just hit the floor. Rule 5, no fishing in the toilet. What would you catch? Here's a hint, obviously not fish. Rule 6, no peeing like a dog in the urinal. Unless you like surprising your neighbors. Not a door. Well, what is it then? I'm not even going to come up with answers, you'll just have to figure it out yourself. Most black bears in Oregon are black. No crap, Sherlock, now tell me something I don't know. Many 3-year-olds have trouble staying within the lines. Maybe, if you practice coloring this turtle, it will help you with your parking. As if it would help anyways. I'm not a toddler. Chances are that you already know who I am, because I exist in many realities, but for the uneducated, I am Microsoft Sam, the best text-to-speech voice to grace the earth. Swah! We is closed. Are you being serious? Did you mean we are closed? Also, you obviously look open to me. The lights are on and everything. You are here.
I don't think I've ever been in a situation where one may ask, "Where are you?" and the only answer is, "Oh, I'm at a freaking moving walkway." You know, those things that you get on, for no reason at an airport. I also think this is the worst location for a sign to tell you where you are. Since this could be literally anywhere. Aye.
Microsoft Windows. Great. Now we have Microsoft Windows wannabes in the loose. What next? Mac? Xbox? Text-to-speech voices? Speed limits? Day, reasonable and prudent. Oh god, I wonder what speeds people consider reasonable. Let's see. 65 miles per hour? No. 70? Nah. 200. Now we're talking. Truck, 60. Fine. Night for all vehicles, 55. Fair enough, considering it's the night. Yo dot 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 skater. Seriously speaking, we like your kickflips but, your trucks are creaking. The noise is loud and the folks are freaking, they are trying to chill but, the blood pressure's peaking. You're close to a park and it's easy walking, check out park get then nobody's squawking. Thanks. What did I just read? I am really confused about how one who has a skateboard is expected to tone down his noise levels to that of a whisper. Warning, there is a chance that you will hit that wedge if you don't duck at a safe time. Ouch. Good luck dealing with that. Sure, it may be trivial at worst, but I thought I'd remind you beforehand. What if that wedge contains sharp edges, and you were expected not to touch the edges of it?